you have the results of the test?
I'm not pregnant yet.
I suppose the only thing to do is to keep trying. Finish my analysis of the habitat. We've reached optimum efficiency.
That's good.
I wish you'd stop wasting your time with the radio. All you're picking up is static. Even if you did locate a signal, it would be useless to us. I don't understand your obsession finding survivors. They would be military anyway. Or worse.
Found out where it's coming from yet?
No. There was a problem with the software. I fixed it, but it'll be a while. The songs are running on a loop. I seriously doubt that there's an actual human being behind the transmission.
Strange selection. Sure not a top 40 station.
Wait a minute. Mozart's magic flute?
What is it? Where are you going?
Those songs were two of the songs that were put on the Voyager spacecraft that was launched back in the 70s.
What?
NASA put certain information on the Voyager about humanity, including some music from Earth, imprinted on a golden record.
Where's Voyager now?
Just outside the solar system, traveling at the slow pace of... It appears humanity's message was received.
Hold on.
It's the only explanation I can fathom. A spacecraft from another planet must have found Voyager adrift, played the golden record, and then sent the songs back to us.
Saying that we got your message. Wasn't a very sophisticated message.
Neither was Voyager's. Back then, information technology wasn't very high-tech. All we had was radio. Television. simple initiation of dialogue. We said hello. They returned the greeting.
What do we say?
You mean how will we respond? We don't. Our radio could never send a signal that would make it that far.
I'm writing a program to send out a message on a loop. Someone's bound to pick it up.
And give away our location?
What?
You don't know who's up there. They could be mutants. They could be the military. We don't want them to find us.
What good is any of this if we don't tell anybody? We have a responsibility to mankind. This message wasn't intended just for us.
No good. There's too much radiation. There's no way that we can send a signal, not even a few miles. Those are the facts.
You don't even want to try. You're afraid. The whole reason we're down here is because you're afraid. And now we're stuck down here because you're a coward.
Kathryn. Kathryn. Remember when we used to drive into town to go to the movies? We used to go every Sunday. We used to pass by a TV station on White Bridge Road, remember that?
Yeah, and
remember the huge tower on top of the hill? Well, that is an antenna. It's over a few miles away. In order for us to tell them anything, we need to speak a common language. Math is that language, but for us to have sophisticated messages, we need to have a digital decoder. A guide for them to figure out how to read the information.
What if they don't get a signal and they pass us by?
You could send something like prime numbers. But that's futile. They already know that we're intelligent. Maybe a message decoded in numbers, digits representing atomic numbers. We could talk through chemistry. about dinner. I'll bring Specs some cheeseburgers, okay?
Okay.
As long as I make it back by night, it should be fine.
Are still here. Temperature much warmer than expected. Radiation levels are much lower than we expected. No evidence of life. Presumably due to the nuclear winter. Lack of plant remains. Probably attributable to wind erosion. I see a large patch of vegetation. Apparently it's being fed by a small stream. I did not expect to see anything like this. Healthy, deep-rooted plant growth. Kathryn, this soil looks suitable for agriculture. Our seeds could grow here. Animal life. This valley is a fully functioning ecosystem. The plant life extends far beyond the stream. Kathryn, this whole area has been reclaimed by life. Kathryn, I know what I have to do.
My name is HR Lofton. My wife and I live underground in a fallout shelter near Niceville, Colorado. 2 weeks ago, we received a transmission from extraterrestrials. I've come to the surface to return their signal, and I have found a valley that supports life. Fellow survivors, let us work together to bring forth a new era. We must gather and be prepared for the future we have all hoped for. My name is H.R. Lofton. My wife and I live underground in a fallout shelter near Niceville, Colorado. 2 weeks ago, we received a transmission from extraterrestrials.
Sure. Tell Slate.
Right.
That's a cut. That was awesome. That's a cut! That's good.
Are you ready? We go now? Should I put it on?
You will. Let me just try with your feet and then right before.
Right here. Yep.
Okay, everyone. Can we lock it up, please? Can we?
Two beats. Or three beats and then start again.
Same direction to stop. Mm-hmm. It's kind of slow, like over there.
Scary.
Dude, I spent some time looking along there. It's kind of scary.
I was on the edge with the camera.
Toilet paper scar.
Do that again?
Do that again?
It doesn't hurt.
It's so weird.
Yeah. Well, this is already down to
you
the...
You guys are real artists.
Under layers.
Kind of screwing down, you know? But maybe if you try to limit the exposure.
Action.
That was much better.
Great.
Okay.
Oh.
Okay?
Yes.
Remember, I'm an actor.
I didn't see the mask.
Yeah. But.
Makeup?
The makeup?
His brains are coming out of his head.
Is that going to sting him?
He's practicing his fuck. This is true filmmaking when he actually rips open his clothes.
I know what I need to know to make movies.
Hi, Ed.
I'd like not to be like an AC.
Maybe I shouldn't have done that. Bob, sorry about that.
Sorry, Bob!
Brain.
Action. Feel like you're unconscious for a bit so we can hold on it?
Yeah.
Camera's ready? Sounds ready?
Sounds ready.
Okay.
So it's just corn syrup, but your eye gets sticky.
Like a little massage.
Bob's getting corn syrup in his eye. Rock out.
Sorry, Bob.
Film is not in, right?
Film is not in.
Okay. Roll sound.
Not in, is it?
Rolling sound, yeah. Speed.
30 dog, take 3.
Roll camera.
Action. Cut.
Remember when we used to drive into town to go to movies? Just every Sunday. Just pass by a TV station on White Bridge Road, remember that?
Yeah, and?
Remember that huge tower on top of the hill? That's an antenna. Big one.
What do you say?
Okay. We're here. Florida Caverns, all right? Come get your picture taken. This is the star of the film.
Oh, box for Bob, is there?
Let me get a critical right there.
Is that a close-up, Dave? Cut.
Kate, meet me on the pole.
Do you have the results of the test?
I'm not pregnant yet.
That is unfortunate.
I've run all the tests that I can. I don't know what the problem is.
I suppose the only thing we can do is to keep trying. Finished my analysis of our habitat. Its efficiency is at 100%.
Are you sure?
My analysis is correct. There was no energy or substance loss.
That's good. You heard anything on the radio?
Of course not.
be difficult to keep that information from you.
I was just trying to make conversation.
What is your obsession with survivors? Any survivors that we would have would most likely be military, the same military that put us here. That's a cut. How was it for camera?
Separated by space, unfortunately, not long.
So this is what we have to do on set. Strip down kind of God and everybody. Right?
You can erect a tarp.
But I've got.
What's the ASA? Oh, 64?
So here too.
Let's get a close up on that.
Jason, cut. Cut. Cut.
And cut.
That's a cut.
Thank you, Bob.
How was it, Jason?
It was with a team, right, Bob? But not bad. Like, no.
Okay.
His eyes did look.
Cut.
That's the cut. How was it, Jason?
This is our
main debut.
Premiere.
Okay, that's all. I can't even stand.
Look, she's a movie star and she's afraid of a camera.
Right.
Can you believe it?
I hate home movies.
Of the 17 films, when 26 first, second, or third prizes, of those 26 subsequent second prizes at the Manchester, England Film Festival, first prize at the Renaissance Film Festival in Los Angeles, first prize in the Silver State Documentary Festival in Nevada, first prize at the Locon Film Festival in Los Angeles, first prize at the Canadian International Video Festival in Ontario, both second and third prizes at the CineArt International Short Film Festival in Hamburg, Germany, and both the first prize in its category and the grand prize at the West Fund. Our students' films have won more than 500 prizes, awards, honors, and featured screenings at national and international. Inaugural screening of the five new thesis films produced by the undergraduate class of 1998. These are, in this order, Golden Record, Perchance, Nueva Trova, Watching, and Bushy. I heard.
Do you have the results of the test?
I'm not pregnant yet.
I suppose the only thing to do is to keep trying. Finish my analysis of the habitat. We've reached optimum efficiency.
That's good.
We should stop wasting your time on the radio. Are you picking up the static? Even if you did locate a signal, it'd be useless to us. I don't understand your obsession with finding survivors. They would be military anyway. Or worse.
Picture this. The ultimate baseball ticket giveaway. A pair of free club-level seats to a Tampa Bay Devil Rays game. Okay, now picture living it up for another game on Fan Appreciation Day, where you just might be the one to win a brand new Dodge Durango. Oh yeah, it's all you, baby. The ultimate baseball ticket giveaway. Register at all Bay Area Eckerd Express photo centers or Dodge dealers and picture yourself a winner. Eckerd, where you always get 50% off express photo processing with your Devil Rays ticket stub.
Carlisle.